Hey everyone, how are you today? So how do you spend your time? Do you ever struggle with that Martha Mary syndrome where you have all these to-dos and then you're struggling to fit God into your day and spend some time praying with Him? If you don't know what Martha and Mary is about, let me share briefly. Martha and Mary are sisters, and Jesus comes over to their house. And Martha's running around being hospitable, making dinner, preparing, probably doing dishes. And Mary is sitting at Jesus' feet, listening to his word. And Martha says to Jesus, "Come on, can you tell her to help me?" And Jesus looks at her and says, "Martha, Martha, you're so anxious about all these things, but you only need one," meaning him. And Mary chose the better part, and I'm not going to take that away from her. Well, what does that mean? I don't believe it's an either or. I believe it's a both and. Let me explain. One day, my husband says, "Are you going to do your taxes?" This has been looming over me. I am not like organized. I have receipts all over from the whole year. And I've been dreading doing it. And I'm now getting to the deadline, like I really need to do this. And so I literally made myself go to Mass. And then I went to adoration afterwards. And I was gonna spend 5 minutes just to say, "Jesus, can you please help me today?" And then I sat there and I was starting to feel calm. And I heard him nudge me and say, "Spend a little more time with me." So that 5 minutes turned into an hour and a half, and I wasn't even worried about the fact that an hour and a half was ticking away. And I not only had my taxes to do, but probably 3 or 4 other things on my list. I walked out of there, literally not running. I drove the speed limit home. And as I was going through receipt by receipt, I was totally calm. I had no anxieties, no worries about what I was doing, that I was doing it correctly. I got done with that, plus the other things on my list. Throughout the process and throughout the day, I kept thanking him. "Lord Jesus, you knew how much of a burden this was going to be with me." And so with him, everything was peaceful and easy. You know, my burden is light. It's crazy. So that was the difference between me. Now I am actually working for him to try and expand his kingdom. But the word "for" changed for me and went to "with." I'm not working for him. I need to work with him every single day through whatever I'm doing. This is applicable to anybody. Whether you're a mom, a homeschooler, maybe you do have a professional career. Maybe you're just doing your tasks at home, laundry or making dinner, the things that you don't really want to do, or even the things that you enjoy doing. If you do it with God, it's so different, so different. And when you wake up in the morning and you decide, because there's a choice every single morning, this is that Martha Mary syndrome, you choose God. You choose to sit with him, meditate on his word, hopefully go to Mass if you can, spend a little time in silence, whether it's in your car, maybe you're on a walk, I don't care, but make that time to sit and give God your time. Close Facebook and those social media outlets. What other things are you wasting your time with? I used to watch Days of Our Lives and watch like episode after episode and fast forward until I sat there one day and I was like, first of all, what am I doing watching this smut, right? There's like same-sex attraction and people having sex with each other outside of marriage. Like, this is not good for me. When I could be reading spiritual readings of the saints, or spending time in adoration, or rereading, you know, the readings, or even getting into the liturgy of the hours. Anything but this. This is such a waste. But again, it's all about living every single moment with God. The good, the bad, thanking Him and having Him be there all throughout your day. Offer up the things that you don't want to do. I remember in adoration, I said, "Oh Lord, I so don't want to do this, but I'm offering it as a suffering, and you can give it to whoever you want, you know? Just help me get through this." And He did. So let's focus on that this week, living with God, not for God, and remembering that you do have your to-dos, but He's also the first priority. So it's a both and live together in all of those tasks. And see what a difference it makes. Love to hear from you. Make a comment if you can on this, on the YouTube video. Because I think it's important when you make that connection. Everything changed for me. I live with God every single moment of the day. That Holy Spirit, whew, one hand in Mary and the other hand with the Holy Spirit. And that is how my life is led now by them. May you walk in the light of the Lord. Go out there and be a light, a ray to someone today. And have a blessed and inspired week. I'll catch you next time.